So privacy is a good thing. So do we have technologies that can help enhance privacy or improve privacy? So here we're going to talk about a few of those. So one of the threats we talked about was traffic analysis. Okay, you know who is talking to who. Okay, so we said communication, who I want to talk to, or if Alice is talking to Bob, somebody else shouldn't be able to figure that out. And they could do that with traffic analysis. What machine is talking to what other machine from source and destination information. So what if we don't want somebody to be able to infer that? So this we can do with this technology called Tor. We'll see what exactly it does, but it's basically sort of anonymous communication is what we're trying to get to here. Let's say what's happening here is, let's say Alice is maybe interacting with a website, but it doesn't want the website to know that it's really Alice, or doesn't even want to know this website to know that, let's say this Bob site is, so this website is operated by Bob. So Alice doesn't want Bob's server to know that the request is coming from her or even the IP address from which it's coming. So one way you can do that is Alice has a client, a Tor client, sort of picks a random path. There are a bunch of Tor nodes that you need to find some subset of those. And it constructs this path in such a way that any node here sort of knows about its predecessor and its immediate successor, but doesn't know who this request has come through in the past, or except its immediate successor, who's the next node that's going to get it. So this guy is told saying, well, just send it to the next node, and the rest of the information is, or the node after that, that information is encrypted with this node's key. So this guy would have no idea that once it sends the message here, it's going to go to this one. Once it comes here, then it decrypts that, you know, the next destination finds out, and it doesn't know who it's going to go after that. So it doesn't have the full picture either. So basically, we create this anonymous communication, or implement anonymous communication as Tor does, by using this kind of a scheme where a set of nodes actually forward the message repeatedly and make use of encryption to sort of know who the message is coming from and where it's going, and that's all they know about. They don't know the full path, and as a result, traffic analysis, no one is going to be able to figure out that Alice is visiting Bob's website unless they have control of all these nodes, which the likelihood of that would be less.